once more to the tomb of Darkulus. For today's review, we have a Lord of Darkness equal almost to myself. All the way from the 1980s, I give you Skeletor. Though more specifically, the Masters of the Universe, Masterverse, Revelation Skeletor. That is one hell of a name, but to be fair, it is one hell of a figure. Now, as a little bit of backstory, Skeletor first appeared in the He-Man and the Masters of the Universe cartoon back in the 80s. Now, this is not quite that Skeletor. Instead, this is a Skeletor from the 2021 Masters of the Universe Revelation cartoon on Netflix. In this series, Skeletor is a lot less bumbling than he was in the 80s. Here, he's a truly threatening figure, and rather imposing. The design they use for him is interesting. It takes design cues from many Skeletor designs, including the original comic book appearances, cartoon, his toys, and the 2000 series. Most interesting of all, however, is the choice of voice actor. He is being voiced by the great Mark Hamill, as most of you would know as the Joker from the Batman cartoons, and as Luke Skywalker from Star Wars. But in this case, it is more important that you know him as the Skeleton King from Super Robot Monkey Team Hyperforce Go. In essence, a sci-fi Skeletor himself. And the voice he brings to this cartoon is eerily similar. But now, to the figure itself. This figure is really well done, I must admit. In a 7-inch scale, full of modern articulation. There are ball joints, double joints, thigh swivels, all of that. And it all looks very good. The appearance of this figure is striking, like the animation model has come to life. Though it is not without its faults. Many of these joints are ludicrously loose. While the rest, the rest are stiff as stone. And some sadistic soul decided to make many of the joints weak. So weak, in fact, as you turn them, you can see the white plastic stressing underneath. I fear one day this figure may simply snap under the right amount of pressure. Though I must admit, the articulation, for what it is impressive. There are no poses for this figure that, if you wish to get them into them, he could not make it. Though how long he would stay in that pose is debatable. As far as accessories go, this is Skeletor, after all. He comes with his famous Havoc staff. The great goat-headed staff looks magnificent in this modern reinterpretation. And he can hold it in both of the included gripping hands. The one is strangely trigger-fingered, though he comes with no blaster. Maybe a future release. He also comes with a fist for his right hand. Perfect for cursing that accursed He-Man, no? One other strange accessory he comes with is the shaping staff, a carryover from the 80s cartoon which, from what I understand, plays an important role in the new cartoon. Though, Skeletor has one other very important accessory. Much like myself, he's a man of style, and what man of style would be complete without an actual cloth cape? It looks good, it is a little tame for my tastes, but if you wish the classic look, you can always remove it and go for a much more 80s Skeletor design. But no figure stands in isolation, does it, my friends? Let us see how this stacks up to some other figures in the collection, shall we? Here he is, first of all, with another 7-inch scale figure, the McFarlane Toys Spawn from the Mortal Kombat 11 series. As you can see, they are both ghoulishly gorgeous figures. And while Skeletor is perhaps slightly simpler with his sculpt, he is no less striking. Here is the Marvel Legends figure, another one with a big toothy grin. Venom. Though he's a 6-inch figure, he does still seem small compared to Skeletor, a true testament to the towering nature of the 7-inch line. He is the staple of the 1980s, Optimus Prime. In this case, the Earthrise version. And, well, how could I resist putting this 80s just wonderfest together? Here he is next to a ghoulish creature himself, the macabre man-thing, the Marvel Legends Build-A-Figure version. I do love how they look together. And of course, there is one figure which he must look good with, the Lion's He-Man figure. And they do look good together, my friends. He-Man stands slightly taller than Skeletor, as he should, but the two together, they are magnificent, born to clash on any shelf. I love it. Well, I'm afraid, my friends, that is it. What do I think of this figure? I recommend it highly. Go find one. They are pretty easy to find, let's face it. They will be on store shelves all over the place. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this review, and alas, I'm afraid it is the last for this series of the Tomb of Draculas. I must go now for the sweet call of the grave. It calls to my soul, but do not worry, friends. As movies have shown us, a good vampire is very hard to keep down. And one day soon, hopefully, you can all return to the Tomb of Draculas.